Hey Virgos, Yana speaks here, and in this video, I am doing your November 2020 love reading. Now, I want to start off by letting you know that all of my readings are general, so they may or may not resonate with you because not every single Virgo is going through the same exact thing. So if you find that this reading does not resonate, then it will be in your best interest to book a private reading with me. All the information to do so will be in the description below. And I also want to let you guys know that I always try to get my private reading, so if you book a private reading with me, let me slow it down. If you book a private reading with me, I always try to get the readings out within 24 hours. Sometimes it could take up to 48 hours, okay? So, I'm going to start off by asking Spirit, what is the overall energy for Virgos this month? What is the Virgo's overall energy this month? What is their overall energy, Spirit? Okay, so your overall energy is the Four of Pentacles. Now, whenever I see the Four of Pentacles, I always see that as someone who's trying to hold on to a connection for their life. So this person could be making you feel like, you know, you may lose them, you know. Essentially, if we're trying to hold on to something really, really tightly, it's because that person is making us feel like, you know, maybe they don't, you know, they may come off like they don't care. Maybe you see that they're dealing with someone else behind your back. Maybe you suspect that they are. We're going to see as we go deeper in the reading, okay? We do have the Ten of Cups. So, you know, I feel like this person makes you really happy. You feel really emotionally fulfilled by this person. This person could be someone that you want to create a family with. This person could be someone you've known for a very long time. You feel very familiar with this person. This isn't like a new person. This is someone you've been dealing with for a while, okay? Those are the Ace of Pentacles here. So you could be wanting to work towards a new beginning, towards something more stable, towards something more grounded. This could also be about finances too. Maybe something's going on between you guys financially, like maybe you're trying to start some type of, you know, new financial opportunity together, maybe going to business together. We do have the Five of Cups here, so there is some type of disappointment. Now, remember I was talking about with the Four of Pentacles, I always see that when people feel like they need to hold on to someone tightly, and usually it's because they in some kind of way feel like they may lose the person. With the Five of Cups, you know, like I said, I talked about some type of disappointment, so you could be really disappointed in this person, you know. Let me ask why you're disappointed in this person. Temperance. You know, it's interesting. I pull Temperance a lot when people are not talking. I don't know why, but whenever I do my prior readings and the person not talking to the other person, or they're like in no contact mode or whatever you want to call it, I tend to pull Temperance a lot. So maybe you, this person not talking. You could be on a break, okay? You know what I'm seeing here too? It's like you don't feel secure with this person. You don't feel protected with this person. You have this sense of I could lose this person at any moment. You know, if I say any little thing or I do any little thing, they'll be ready to leave me, you know? And you're very disappointed. You're very heartbroken about that. Maybe this person has already, you know, kind of distanced themselves from you. And I feel like with Temperance, like you're trying to be balanced about this whole thing. You're trying to be peaceful about this whole thing. You know, you're willing to compromise with this person because you do care about them. And I feel like you do want to be with them. You know what I mean? And yeah, we have Judgment here. This is about wanting a second chance to do things the right way. Wanting a reset, a rebirth. But you can't just want the rebirth. This person has to want it too. The Eight of Pentacles. Yeah, you're willing to put in the work. This could be related to some type of money too, like I was saying. Maybe you feel like this person only cares about you because of what you do for them, but you still can't help how you feel for them. You know what I mean? We have the Knight of Cups, so this makes sense because the Knight of Cups, I always see the Knight of Cups as someone who's so like irresistible, someone who is hard to just walk away. It's like someone who's just so dreamy. You know, it's people that they're just dreamy. Like you look at them, you're like, ah, oh, God, you're so dreamy. You're so like, you're just everything. The Knight of Cups is always that vibe to me. It's someone who's like romantic. They're seducer. They know the right things to say. You know, they could literally talk the panties and the drawers off of anybody. They look good, they smell good, they make you feel good, they romance you. They know how to get you open. This person has you open. This is why you're willing to do whatever to get them back. The King of Cups. And I feel like with the King of Cups being here, like, you know deep down inside this person does have feelings for you. But they don't always, like, let you know how they feel. You know what I mean? Now, some people may say, oh, you know, you're not being realistic. This person doesn't care. When someone cares about you, you know that they care about you. When someone loves you, like, you know, you feel it. So, you know, you could just be feeling like you guys are going through a rough patch. So we're going to see as we go deeper into this reading how this person feels about the Virgos. Okay, so how does this person feel about the Virgos? Yeah, the Ten of Swords. So when I see the Ten of Swords, you know, this could be this person feeling like they've reached their final straw with this connection. This could be why I was saying earlier, I feel like there hasn't been much communication between you and this person, okay? Yeah, the Eight of Swords. Yeah, so they could be feeling confused. They could be feeling trapped. They could feel stuck. They could feel like they don't know what to do in regards to the situation. So this is why they're being distant, okay? Yeah, the Ace of Cups, they do feel an overflow of emotion because, like I said before, this person does have feelings for you. So this is why they don't know what to do. See, to me, someone's not going to be confused about you if they don't care at all. You know what I mean? The Queen of Swords. There could be someone in their life that they go to for advice that is very critical of this connection that you two have. This could be like an older woman. It could be like a mother, a grandmother, an older aunt. This could be someone on your side too. This could also be how they feel about you, because we did ask how they feel about you. So with the Queen of Swords, this could be them feeling like... See, the Queen of Swords is very logical. She's very critical. She cuts through the bullshit. You know, she doesn't tolerate stupidity. She's intimidating. So for this person to feel this way about you, maybe you weren't the most, like, affectionate. Maybe you weren't the most loving. Maybe you said things that really affected them and hurt their feelings. Maybe when you argue with them, you say things that are mean and that, you know, cuts through them. You could be nasty with your words, and that could be why this person is feeling a way towards you, okay? We do have the Seven of Swords here. There's some type of deception. The Ten of Pentacles. Remember, I was picking up something with money, Ten of Pentacles. I mean, I feel like this person does have feelings for you. I feel like this person was trying to create like a family unit with you. They were trying to make money with you, and like, you guys were supposed to, like, be coming together and, like, creating something, like, you know, lifelong. Like, this is, like, supposed to be, like, a long-term relationship. With that Seven of Swords being here, like, why do they feel the Seven of Swords for you? They, like, I'm gonna be honest, they don't have the best feelings for you. Like, they feel like you're, like, a bad person. So why is the Seven of Swords here? Why do they feel the Seven of Swords? Seven of Swords is about someone feeling like you're sneaky, deceptive, you're a liar. Why is the Seven of Swords here? The Magician. This has something to do with money. Two of Cups. The Two of Wands. The Tower. Was there some type of business deal, something that y'all was supposed to be? It doesn't even have to be money. You know, Pentacles is about effort too. There could have been something that they felt like you were supposed to do that you did not do. The Two of Cups, this person. I feel like this person at one point did think that you were their soulmate, but now they question that because they view you as being deceptive. So now they're at a crossroads with the Two of Wands, trying to figure out what's the next step to take with you. I feel like with the Magician, though, even though they feel like you're deceptive, they still want to make things happen. So it's almost like they view you in a negative light, but they still want to make stuff happen, you know? And that tower's right there. I feel like this person's seeing you in a different light. It's not a positive light. They don't see you the way that they used to see you. Like, to them before, you were like perfect, but now they question that. You know, to them before, you were their soulmate, now they question all of that. But even though they question it, they're still choosing to see where things go. You know, they're still choosing to do this. So, okay, so I'm gonna ask for it for some advice. What do they need to know about this situation? Deception. Wow. I pulled the Seven of Pentacles. Deception. Someone is wearing a false self mask in this relationship. You deserve love. You are lovable. Make the effort. Great love is worth taking the steps you're guided to take. Remember, I said that the Pentacles don't always have to be about money, it could just be effort. So when I see this, maybe you were deceptive. Maybe you weren't like cheating or anything, because I don't feel like you were cheating. But maybe you weren't being honest about something, right? And maybe you're in this place where you're trying to figure out, like, you know what I think it is? Maybe you were in the wrong, right? And you may not see that you were in the wrong. Maybe you're starting to see that you were in the wrong, right? And maybe you're waiting on this person to come around and talk to you. But this might be one of these situations where you need to contact them. You need to reach out to them. You need to make the effort because you do deserve love. You are lovable. So maybe you're used to like being deceived and being like the one that's done wrong, where you're usually get done wrong and you can't even see the error in your own ways, right? But maybe you're starting to slowly see it. And spirit is saying that it is okay for you to contact this person and say, listen, I'm wrong and I'm sorry and let's fix this. You know, a lot of times when you are a victim, you can't even recognize when you're wrong because you're used to being the victim. I feel like that's what spirit is saying. So you did something that really upset this person that they viewed as being backstabbed and betrayed, right? And you need to make it right. You need to apologize. You know, this they want you need to apologize. You're in the wrong, essentially. All right. So I'm gonna end this reading here and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.